As we continue our 33 days to morning glory with Father Michael Gately or Gatley, 33 days to morning glory here with you. And let me attempt to do day 19, 20, 21, and 22 with you. Again, playing a little catch up and consolidation here. On day 19, it's about the daily examine, encouraging us, as Mother Teresa did as well, and many great saints, the daily examination of conscience, asking God to forgive us for our sins each evening, particularly commonly done at night, can be done anytime. And then also, and the important part as well, to give thanks to God, saying sorry for our sins and thanking Him for the many blessings. Day 20, a reflection on the covenant that we can have or do have with our Blessed Mother. If we promise to give ourselves over to her, then she in turn promises to protect us, care for us, love us, and lead us ever close to her Son, Jesus. Day 21, let me just read a little quote from Mother Teresa that stuck out at me. The greatest evil is the lack of love and charity, the terrible indifference towards one's neighbor. People today are hungry for love, for understanding, love, which is much greater and which is the only answer to loneliness and great poverty. And so again, challenging us to reach out and love others, Mother Teresa, and of course she did that in a very profound way in her love for the poor. Day 22, our author continues on to reflect, or starts the reflection more on the writings of Pope John Paul II, or Blessed John Paul II, and starts off making reference to his devotion to Our Lady of Fatima, and also sharing the time John Paul II was shot twice, and his recovery, and establishing the Divine Mercy Sunday that's now on our church calendar. I guess, too, briefly, I'll be happy to share with you that I was once in Fatima, Portugal, found it a wonderful experience there, celebrating Mass and praying the Rosary and spending a couple few days there at that holy shrine where Our Blessed Mother appeared to those three small children with her messages to them. Of course, praying for world peace and praying the Rosary, I believe, was two main themes, promoting the Rosary and praying it particularly for world peace. There's sometimes the intrigue of the secrets of Fatima, especially the third secret and such. I won't attempt to explain it, nor do I think I could do it well, but if you find that intriguing, invite you to do some research and prayer on those secrets of Fatima that were revealed. And so let me close with prayer. I guess, too, real quick on the Fatima secrets. It's, of course, ever so important that we do believe it is the Pope and the bishops that have the ultimate ability to, with authority, reveal church teaching and reveal the proper interpretation of scriptures to us. So the idea of end times and secrets and such, people can get kind of out of hand with it all. But as Catholics, as good Christians, we believe it's the bishops of the church that gave us the Bible properly, and continue to protect it, interpret it, the messages that we need, the messages that we have. They do that with authority and properly. Page 89, the closing prayer. Come, Holy Spirit, living in Mary, have mercy on us and on the whole world.